Welcome to the When Blue is Green project. We are a 5-year, $10 million grant awarded by the USDA and NIFA. Our goal is to increase domestic seafood production and consumption in the Midwest. Behind me, you can see an aquaponics system. If you're not familiar with aquaponics, it's the coupling of recirculating aquaculture and hydroponics. You can see Peter down here. He's creating waste. There's a pump over here that'll pump this water up and into our grow bed. Once in the grow bed, we have shale. Shale is a porous bead where bacteria can take root and convert the ammonia from Peter's waste into nitrogen for the plants to grow. The water then circulates all the way back down through this pipe and goes back into his fish tank, leaving Peter with non-toxic, ammonia-free water. As you can see, aquaponics is a closed-loop system, which means all of the water is recirculated through the entire system and the nutrients are reused. This system is one of 6 of our pilot-scale aquaponic systems here in the greenhouse. It works very similarly to the previous unit we just looked at. I'll start here at the fish tank. This fish tank houses about 15 tilapia. If you follow the pipe down at the base, it'll come into a sump tank. This sump tank catches all of the fish solid waste before getting pumped up and into our biological filter. This biological filter mimics the same thing that the shale would do in our previous system. Using high surface area beads inside of the system, the bacteria can latch on and convert the ammonia into nitrate. The now nitrate-rich water will flow from this biological filter into this grow bed. There's plenty of nitrate available to help these plants grow. Any excess overflow will go into this tank below the grow bed. This helps us control the water volume in each of our systems, creating a closed-loop system. In this system, we grow tilapia and lettuce because lettuce is a non-temperamental plant. We grow our lettuce in these rafts using peat moss plugs. These plugs will have the seed in the top. We wait for it to germinate, and then we'll plant them right here. And in a couple of weeks, they'll look like this. The final part of our integrated aquaponic system is anaerobic digestion. We don't have an anaerobic digester here in the greenhouse, but we do use the fish solid waste sludge for the anaerobic digestion. This biological filter will use back pressure to separate off the water from the solid waste. Once I open this valve, the solid fish waste from our system will come out through this tube. We'll then use that in our anaerobic digester. Anaerobic digestion is the natural fermentation of waste. That waste will then produce methane. Methane that we can then use in a biogas boiler to then power the pumps of this system, cutting down on cost and creating a truly closed loop system. Our integrated aquaponic system not only involves our aquaponic systems that you saw earlier, but also our algae growth unit and our anaerobic digester. Our algae growth unit, as you can see behind me, is growing tetracelmus and chlorella strains of algae. This algae is grown using the fish wastewater discharge. The discharge is very high in phosphorus and nitrogen, which helps our algae grow. This algae will then be centrifuged and separate off the clean water from the algal paste. The clean water will then go back into our aquaponic systems, and the algae will then be used to extract the proteins and phenolic compounds. This way, no nutrients go to waste, and all of the excess nutrients from our system, instead of being discharged out into the environment, are discharged right here into our algae tanks.